Is turmeric really helpful to reduce inflammation? Is it safe to use high doses of turmeric in supplement capsules? Is it enough to add turmeric to my diet? Will I get the anti-inflammatory benefits? I'll answer these questions in this video. So let's talk about turmeric today. Turmeric is a plant in the ginger family. The stems and roots are ground into a powder that is used in many Asian cooking, and it's the main ingredient in curry. I love cooking with turmeric, and my favorite dish is chicken masala. Turmeric contains a yellow-colored substance called curcumin that can be used in cosmetics, pigmentation, or foods. In about 1,000 milligrams of turmeric, there is about 30 to 50 milligrams of curcumin. There are many animal studies that show antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties of curcumin. There have been various scientific studies showing that turmeric offers several health benefits. The main one is anti-inflammatory properties. Inflammation is a reaction of the body to some injury or when we need to heal a bone fracture or a tendon rupture. However, there are situations that the person's own immune system will attack itself. We call this autoimmune diseases. One of these is rheumatoid arthritis. A meta-analysis of 8 randomized trials supports the benefits of turmeric at about 1,000 milligrams a day in the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. The patients in these trials reported improvement in morning stiffness, walking in the morning, and joint swelling after 3 months of treatment. It seems that the effects were similar to using non-prescription, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or NSAIDs, like ibuprofen or diclofenac. I have another video about NSAIDs to explain what they do. Now, listen to this carefully. Because turmeric has shown some effects for rheumatoid arthritis, there are a lot of claims that it can also be used for other kinds of diseases where there is some low-grade inflammation, like heart diseases, diabetes, cancer, and even Alzheimer's disease. There has been some speculation from preclinical studies that turmeric and the active substance curcumin could reduce inflammation after a major surgery. To look at this, a high-quality Canadian randomized control trial published in 2018 by Dr. Garg and colleagues. They examined the effects of curcumin at high doses in preoperative of abdominal aortic aneurysm repair in 10 hospitals in Canada. The patients received either 2,000 milligrams twice a day for 4 days or a placebo tablet. They looked at 4 types of biomarkers of tissue inflammation in the hours and days after surgery, and there was no difference between the 2 groups, and the group that received curcumin had higher risks of post-operative kidney injury than the group that received placebo. So when you buy supplements, any type of supplements, remember, they are not regulated the same way that medicines are. So they may say that some tablets contain quantities of substances, but that may not be totally accurate. Manufacturers of natural health products can sell a product and claim health benefits without having to obtain the same regulatory approvals, the same supporting evidence that would be needed if they were studying a drug. if the person decides to use turmeric or curcumin supplements, it is important to check if they also contain piperine, a substance found in black pepper, which helps in the absorption of curcumin. But if the curcumin supplement does not contain piperine that you buy, then just add some black pepper when you have the supplement to increase the absorption. How about getting curcumin from regular diet? Well, the amount of turmeric and curcumin in diet varies depending on the products that are used. The average Indian diet contains around 2000 milligrams of turmeric a day, which provides around 60 milligrams of curcumin per day. Are there side effects of turmeric and curcumin? Well, remember that high doses or long-term use of turmeric may cause gastrointestinal problems, similar to the effects of NSAIDs or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. So doses above 2000 milligrams of turmeric per day are not recommended. Please don't forget that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is any medical emergency, please go to the nearest hospital close to your house. Below this video, in the description, there is a link to a document that you can download, and you will find the summary of what this video contains. If you like this video, don't forget to give your thumbs up here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and to turn on the notifications so then you get alerted when I post new videos here. There is a share button here too, and you can use this button to share this video with anyone that you think need to hear this message. I have many other videos in my channel. Check here for other videos too. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.